These come from this part of the world, between the Black Sea and the Caspian Sea, the Caucasus Mountains, but they've been exported all over the world. This, it actually comes from way over here, and you can find that around the world too in warmer climates. Now you might be inclined to think that this comes from over here, but actually it doesn't. It's from here. However, our secret ingredient, it does come from here. Of course, I suppose it's no longer a secret ingredient what it is, but that's all right. We share secrets here because we... Well, hello there. I'm Green Deane, and welcome to my wide world of weeds and my 108th video here at eattheweeds.com. I've already done one video on the Firethorn, or the Pyracantha coccinea. So you can watch that video to learn the particulars about the plant. There is a Pyracantha near you. This video was specifically requested and about the sauce. And at the same time, my Pyracantha was cooperating with a really nice, large crop of fruit, so we put them together. And what you hear in the background is my fireplace. Yes, it's 48 outside here in Florida. The Pyracantha is in the greater rose family, just like the apple, and it has a flavor kind of like a mealy little apple. And like the apple, you do not eat the seeds because the seeds contain hydrogen cyanide, which is released in your when you digest them and can hurt you. So you do not eat these seeds. But once you get rid of the seeds, you've got yourself a nice little fruit to work with. So what we're going to do is we're going to briefly revisit the shrub and then come back and into the kitchen.
While the pulp of these are edible raw, the most common good food to make from these is jelly. However, I already have enough Pyracantha jelly now to feed a football team, and I've already done a couple of videos on making jelly. And there are plenty of Pyracantha Firethorn jelly recipes on the internet. So today we're going to make these into a sauce, which is almost always an alternative to jelly with just about any fruit. There is no Firethorn sauce recipe on the internet. Mine is the first and the original. So the first thing I need is about 3 pints of these. Pick carefully because they have a lot of sharp thorns, which is what the antha part of the name means. The pyra part is fire for the color. And we're going to add a little fire to it as well. This first step is very similar to making jelly. First thing I'm going to do is I got about 3 pints or 6 or 7 cups here of the palms, very nice palms, and I'm going to cover them with water. I might have to get just a little more in there. That's good. To that I'm going to add the juice of 1 lime. The zest of 1 lime, and the old secret ingredient here, well not really, 1 minced chipotle pepper with adobo sauce. Now we're going to bring that to a simmer and let that cook for about 30 minutes. Notice that I'm cooking these with the seeds in them. That's not a problem. We'll throw the seeds and the pulp away after we've extracted the essence. You don't want to eat the seeds, cooked or raw. Oh, a few by chance won't bother you, but more will. So that's what we're looking to do, seeds and all. This has simmered for 30 minutes. So what I'm going to do now, besides steaming up my lens, is I'm going to mash it and then let it simmer for another 30 minutes. Now that I have filtered out my juice, got rid of all the particulates, got rid of all the pulp, got rid of the seeds, I'm going to reduce the sauce by about half. And Then we'll start to add some sugar. We'll get to that in just a moment. I've now reached the subjective part. It's quite tart, so I'm going to add at least a half a cup of sugar here just to see how I can affect the flavor. Getting hot there. Well, I can smell the chipotle pepper. Give this a try. I'm going to add a little bit more. But another third of a cup. I'm not a sugar fan. But sometimes things are just a little too tart. This is also time to put the cornstarch in. Remember, this is a sauce, this is not a jelly. Oh, that's nice. Bit on the tart side and sweet at the same time. So now we have to add our cornstarch. May not have to use all of it. Always add a cornstarch mixture when your liquid is very hot. There we go. Keep on stirring as it cools off. Now I'm getting some good texture to that. See that? You gotta be careful at this stage, it can bubble up and burn you. See my texture? That's a good texture for a sauce. Not too thick, not too runny. And we're going to try this, but now that it's thicker, it's going to be hotter, it's going to hold the heat longer, so I don't want to burn my tongue. So we'll have to cool it off here a little. So here we have our Pyracantha sauce, or a Firethorn sauce. It's very reminiscent of tart apples. It has its astringency to it, but since we've added the sugar, the astringency is ameliorated to a certain point. Plus, it has that chipotle pepper in there, so there's just a little bit of heat. This is not a gourmet sauce. It's just a nice sauce that you can make out of what you have around to particularly cut through fatty meats, like such as goose or duck or chicken, turkey, things like that. Or even pork. It'd be very nice on pork as well. Just a very nice everyday sauce that you can use that comes from, well, basically an escaped weed. Well, I'm sure many of you have seen this. Leftover turkey, yes, from Thanksgiving. Just the thing that needs a sauce to pick it up. You want to try here? Yeah, no turkey. Woohoo. Mm. Mm. Oh my God. So good. Be excellent on ham too, I think. Now I want to thank you for joining me here on my 108th video. This one about the Pyracantha sauce. For more information or about it, or to learn where my next class is going to be, you can go to eattheweeds.com and the recipe's there as well. So until next time, this is Green Deane. I want you to think green. I want you to live green, I want you to eat green, and well, sometimes that includes pink. Pyracantha sauce. Toodles. Oh boy. Gosh, where are the cats?